So guys, let's continue with our short run law of variable proportions. Now slowly we will move towards the numerical practice, but before understanding what the numerical values of TP, AP and MP mean, here are some, in short I have written some terms which you will understand. Like in the graph, when you observe, when MP is greater than AP, means you can see here, in stage 1, MP you will find that it is always greater than the AP curve. Let me just put the AP curve with another marker so you will understand better. So, MP curve here is always greater than the AP curve, which means that whenever MP is above the AP curve, AP will rise. See, AP is rising. What is the reason that we have seen? But now, in short, you have to train your mind to remember these things, that whenever MP curve is above the AP curve will always continue to rise. Then, after MP curve is rising, AP curve is also rising, means there has to be a point where MP will be equal to AP. This is your point of inflection. You call this as a point of inflection, where AP and MP will become equal. So at the point of inflection, the MP is later falling down, but AP is at its maximum value. At this point of inflection, AP is maximum, because as we studied in previous session, that after the point of inflection, AP will fall because the TP is also rising at a diminishing rate, right? Moving forward, after that, when MP is decreasing, means the MP curve goes below the AP curve, because after the point of inflection, when AP curve is cutting the MP curve, AP curve is also overtaking the MP curve, so it is moving above. So when MP is less than AP, meaning that AP curve is above the MP curve, what happens? AP starts to fall. Okay, now having understood this entire curves and their shapes, now you have to understand that in all these conditions of MP, what happens? MP is increasing, it can also be zero, and it can also turn on to negative, but average product is always and always positive. It might be less than MP or it can be more than MP, but it can never be negative, because the total output can never be negative. If the total output is never negative, how will the average be negative? So average will never be negative. The quantity produced can never be negative. That is why it is said that AP always has a positive value, and AP curve will always stay above this x-axis. The only curve that crosses the x-axis to its negative quadrant is the MP curve. Okay, so in this entire law of proportion, you have understood these things. And also one more thing, that is needless to say, that when TP is highest, MP will be zero. Okay, here it is maximum, TP is maximum, and MP is obviously zero. Okay, now with this we can now easily move forward with some numericals. Now this is our numerical, where you are given this table And in this table, you are given various units of labor which are variable. Means here we assume that the one factor fixed is say land and the other variable factors are of labor. And you are given the details for AP and MP. Now there are also, as you can see, some blanks which you have to fill. So let's start this very logically, that average product is given to you. Means how is the average product determined? It is an average of total product. And how is the marginal product determined? It is the difference between two consecutive total products. So what you have to understand here is, without calculating TP, you cannot calculate the AP and MP. So we will directly move to calculating the TP. Now, even though the TP column is not given as blank in your question, you have to move logically. When you see that average product and marginal product is given in your question, you know that these two are a byproduct of what? Total product. So directly we will calculate total product. Now if the average product is TP upon Q, means from this how will you derive the total product? It is simple. You are going to multiply the average product by the quantity that you have produced, and then we will get TP. Now it is not so difficult to calculate TP. If 8 is the average product of one unit, total product is also 8. Then the total product is 20, matlab 10 multiplied by 2. But then here you don't have the average product. Means the total product you won't get. But whatever products you are getting, you first fill that. Now you can get this, right? 9 4s are 36. Again there is a blank, so you won't get it. Then the last one is 7. Okay? So 7 6 are 42. Okay, then we can move forward. MP. How do you get MP? MP curve is nothing but TP of N minus TP of N minus 1. Means you are calculating the difference between two additional products that you have produced. So here you can see whatever blanks you have got in AP, you have in MP. So you can calculate. For example, let's say the output produced at 2 units of input used was 20 and the marginal product for next unit is 10. Means the third additional input utilized is producing 10 extra products. Means here you can get it as 30. Correct? How did you get this 30? You added 20 units plus 10 units of marginal product. Correct? Moving forward, again we have a blank, but we know that at 4 units of input use, the total product is 36, and at 5 units of input use, the marginal or the additional product that you produce is 40, means the total product at 5 units utilized is 36 plus 4 is nothing but 40 units. Correct? So this is how you calculated TP. Now you can easily fill in the blanks. Let's fill the blanks also. Now here, what happens? MP. What is the additional product that you produce using one additional unit of input? How did you determine one additional unit of input is? Before using this one input, you were not using any input. If there are no input, there cannot be any production. Means the MP will always be zero. So from 0 to you are moving towards 8, means you produced 8 extra units by employing just one unit of input. Moving forward, you produced 12. Now 12 output for 2 units of input means you have to take difference between these two. That is, you produced extra 12 units. Moving forward, now see it is tallying automatically. Like from 20, you produced 30, means you produced additional 10 which was already given in the question. Then you can move forward. From 30, you moved to producing 36, means now you produced 6 more. And from 36 to 40, it is 4. And from 40 to 42, it is 2. Simple. Now for average product, you just have to take the product of your TP. The average of your TP. 30 is produced at using 3 units of input means 30 output and 3 units of input, the average is nothing but total product divided by the quantity of input used. So 30 divided by 3, you will get 10 as your AP. Now moving forward, here also the same thing, 40 divided by 5, you can get as 8. So this is nothing but your numerical calculations of TP, AP and MP, right? So here also you can determine the stages in this numerical example itself. For example, if you see the marginal product, if you have understood the entire curve, that marginal product curve initially in the initial stage 1 of increasing returns, it increases up to the point of inflection. Now what is the point of inflection? It is where AP is equal to MP. Now let us see which units give AP and MP to be the same value. This 1, 2, 3 means 3. At 3 units you will get point of inflection. If this is point of inflection, it means everything above this was your stage 1, where MP is increasing from 8, from 0 to 8. 0 is your origin. From 0 to 8 and 8 to 12, your MP is increasing. This is stage 1 and it will continue to increase up to the point of inflection, means where AP is equal to MP, means unit 3. After that, as you can see, your MP is decreasing. If your MP is decreasing, then this will become your stage 2. And after this, if it becomes 0 and then negative, then this will be your stage 3. But as I told you in the previous session, it is not necessary that every business will go through stage 3. This is your stage 2. And one important point that you have to keep in mind, that most of the businesses always operate in stage 2. Okay, because the MP is decreasing. And now you can also see that I told you just a few minutes earlier that after the point of inflection, AP is always above the MP curve, meaning AP has comparatively higher values than the MP. Here at 4 units, MP is 6 but the AP is 9. And see, as you can observe, MP is 4, AP is 8. So after the point of inflection in stage 2, the values of AP will always be greater than the values of MP, indicating that the AP curve will cut MP at its maximum and then it will overtake. When you see the all values of AP, you will see that the point of inflection is the only point where the value of AP is the highest. Means the 10 is highest, but this cannot be the point of inflection since MP is still higher. Point of inflection can only be where AP and MP have same values, are equal. That is the end of stage 1 and beginning of stage 2. Okay. This is the next numerical of calculating AP, MP from the given question. So as you can see, if the values of AP and MP are given, you need to calculate the value of TP, because TP is the only deriving factor of AP and MP. So let's understand, AP is nothing but the average of TP and MP is the additional product, TP of N minus TP of N minus 1. So first, whatever blanks are given in AP, just ignore those blanks, and from the given values of AP you can multiply to find the values of TP. So let's find the value of TP. The first value is obviously 16. The second value is 20 is the average at 2 units. So obviously, what you are going to do here, using AP, you have to multiply the values of quantity of inputs used. And if you want to see the values of TP with values of NP, then you will have to consider the additional increase or additional decrease. The second total product is 40. For the third product, you see that the AP is blank. So you won't be able to calculate by multiplication. So instead, you move towards MP. If the marginal product or the additional product is 20 units, you know that from previous 40 to additional 20, now your total product that a producer produces using the units of labor are 60. Then later also you can calculate, so on and so forth. Okay, you can complete this exercise plus more other exercise that I will give you. But the main point that you have to remember is what? That even if AP and MP are given in the question with the blanks, what you have to do is first you have to calculate the deriving factor, which in this case is that of TP. Okay.